ZWO has launched its new ASI585MC-Air, and in this video we'll talk about its features, its advantages, and its potential problems. Let's get into it. This camera is very interesting to say the least. It is a fully integrated smart camera that promises to make astrophotography more simple, portable, and user-friendly than ever before. Its unique selling point is its simplicity. This camera combines an imaging sensor, a guiding camera, and ZWO's famous ASI Air system into a single compact unit, which is reasonably priced at $799. It really is all-in-one combo, so you no longer need tangled cables, heavy laptops, or multiple devices. You don't even need a guide camera or guide scopes. Just one neat system for everything. Traditionally, astrophotography setups are complex. You need separate cameras, a guiding system, laptops, and a maze of cables. This camera wants to change this. It wants to do away with all the complexities and just give us all-in-one device. So, it's also got built-in Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and 256GB of storage, and a powerful control app. So you can capture, process, and share images of the night sky directly from your smartphone or tablet. No laptop is required. It's kind of like C-Star, but for proper astrophotography. Let's talk about what is inside this camera. At the heart of this camera is Sony's IMX585 color sensor. This sensor is known for its great sensitivity and image quality. With 8.29 megapixels and 91% quantum efficiency and zero amp glow, the sensor is a good quality one to capture everything from faint nebula to dabble into some planetary photography. The sensor is capable of high-speed frame rate up to 46.9 frames per second at full resolution, making it a good option for astrophotography, especially for planetary stuff. The main camera has two-stage thermoelectric cooling. It is capable of reducing sensor temperature up to 35 degrees Celsius. This would help in cutting down on noise. Another standout feature of this device is its integrated guiding camera, which is awesome because you don't need another guide camera or guide scope. This cuts all of that out. This guide camera uses SC2210 monochrome sensor, the same sensor which is used in ZWO's well-regarded ASI 220 mini guide camera. In terms of USB ports, you can expect four USB 2.0 ports that will allow you to connect your filter wheel and focuser and so on. You don't really need any power boxes or anything of that sort with this camera. This camera has got you covered. In addition to the USB 2.0 ports, the camera also has a USB-C port, which can be used for high-speed data transfer or even firmware updates. So let's talk about some of the advantages of this device. Well, I expect this camera will be a game changer for those who value simplicity and portability. Its all-in-one design eliminates the need for multiple devices and messy cable management. This camera is ideal for portable setups. Another advantage of this is that it's beginner-friendly. The streamlined workflow removes much of the technical intimidation that often comes with astrophotography for beginners. But not just beginners, it also can be used by experienced people who value lightweight and travel-friendly option that doesn't sacrifice performance. Another key advantage is that this camera has a high quantum efficiency of 91%, and it also has a low readout noise, which means that it should work well with deep sky imaging, but also with planetary imaging. You can also use this to do electronically assisted astronomy, EAA, and I think it should perform well. Well, there's a lot going for this camera, but there are some potential problems as well. For starters, it has limited upgradability. The integrated design means that you can't really update individual components. If you want a better sensor or better guiding camera, You just need to replace the whole lot. Another potential problem is the performance bottlenecks. While the image sensor IMX585 is capable of capturing images at 46.9 frames per second. The ASI-Air system limits its real-time output to around 10 frames per second. This is because ASI-Air is not yet capable of processing images over 10 frames per second. This is fine for most users, but planetary people who rely on high-speed capture may find this disappointing. Another thing is that it has reduced dynamic range in HCG mode. The high conversion gain mode reduces noise, but also significantly reduces the full well capacity to about 2,600 electrons. This can make it harder to capture images with both bright and faint details without overexposing highlights. Finally, at $799, this camera offers strong value for its features, but people who already own guiding or control gear might find it better value in standalone ASI585MC Pro, which offers similar imaging performance for less. To sum up, this camera is powerful. It's got a lot for it. It's a thoughtfully engineered solution for those who want to spend less time setting up and more time capturing. It's great for beginners, for those who like portability. But those seeking long-term flexibility may want to weigh the trade-offs. What do you think of this? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this conversation, please like and subscribe for more content like this.